This is potentially a game changer because Ant is claiming that it's able to train AI models using Chinese chips from the likes of Alibaba and Huawei at a 20% cheaper cost. And it's training models that uses the MoE machine learning model. This is mixture of experts machine learning model. Essentially, it breaks down a task into small data sets to make it more efficient. You can imagine it's similar to employing a team of experts, each focusing on a specific part of the problem to enhance the overall efficiency. So typically such an approach will require the very high bandwidth memory chips like NVIDIA's chips, which are under export control. But Ant is saying they are able to achieve the same results as if you were using an H800 chips, which is the scale back version of the NVIDIA chips that were tailored especially for the Chinese market in order to meet the export restrictions. And it's also claiming that they were able to beat Meta on some of these benchmarks, such as English language understanding. But it claims that there are still some teething problems with training, because especially when it comes to stability, if you just change the hardware or the AI structure, model structure, just a little bit, it leads to a jump in error rate. But still, it's an important breakthrough because it would really lower and slash that development cost, because the MoE model has been pretty prohibitive because it relies on those chips that are not really accessible to smaller firms. And it could put China on track to being self-sufficient in the tech race if they're able to make more efficient computational models that do not rely on these very advanced chips.
Okay, so a game-changing moment. Does it fundamentally then shift the rules of the game and the calculus for policymakers when it comes to US-China tech competition? Mm.
Yeah, so the way this competition has evolved was because of the policies from the US. And the two sides, US and China, are competing on very, very different paradigms, because recently we had Jensen Huang saying that the DeepSeek moment, the fears around that and whether that would affect his company is unfounded, because he says companies will still need better chips with greater computational capacity, and he's still doubling down on his strategy of having bigger GPUs with more transistors, more memory, more processing cores. But China is going the opposite way, where they're going for cheaper chips, but they are changing and making the computational model more efficient. So it's a very different way of doing things here.